A cabinet secretary, another one out at the White House after a stack of ethics questions. It's not the only legal test or ethical test facing the Trump administration. Not by a long shot, it turns out. Before or after the election, if Trump ran it, authorities want to know about it. Our senior political analyst, John Avlon, has your reality check, sir.
That's right, John. So Interior Secretary Ryan Zinke is out, making him the fourth Trump cabinet official to leave under an ethics cloud in less than 2 years. Zinke was the subject of no less than 15 investigations during his tenure, the latest involving a land deal made with a Halliburton executive in his Montana hometown. And then there's the lavish travel, taking a security detail on a personal vacation to Greece and Turkey. But outlandish travel and overblown security have snagged all the cabinet secretaries who've been pushed out to date. For example, former EPA Scott Pruitt is the reigning champ, having burned through more than $3 million taxpayer dollars in travel and security expenses, including taking a complete detail on family vacations, football games, and trips home to Oklahoma. That's not to mention the $43,000 soundproof phone booth and a sweetheart deal on a $50 a month Capitol Hill rental from a lobbyist, among about a dozen investigations into Pruitt to date. Now, former Health and Human Services Secretary Tom Price blew through $1.2 million on lavish travel, and nearly all of it, some 20 trips, violated federal requirements, according to the Inspector General. And the Inspector General of the VA found, quote, serious derelictions in former Secretary David Shulkin's 10-day trip to Europe, which was loaded with sightseeing jaunts and left taxpayers on the hook for airfare and other expenses for his wife. But that's just the cabinet, folks, and far from the most serious of it. A new report from the Washington Post finds that virtually every organization Donald Trump has led over the past 10 years is facing some form of investigation. At least six in total, being looked into by everyone from Robert Mueller to multiple state AGs. Now, we know all about the alleged campaign finance violations to pay off women weeks before the election, and the Trump transition team under investigation for contacts with Russians. But now there's the inaugural committee, and questions about whether any of the $107 million that was donated to it came from foreign nationals, which would be illegal. There's a pair of emolument lawsuits trying to determine whether Trump used his status as president to fill his company's coffers with foreign government money. There's the New York State lawsuit over the Trump Foundation, a charity accused of using its money in unorthodox ways, like purchasing a gigantic portrait of Trump himself and paying off his business's legal settlements. And who could forget Trump University, which ran afoul of the law for everything from even calling itself a university to claims that students were defrauded through false ads and empty promises. And those are just the big ones. Now, with a new class of Democrats heading to Washington with investigatory powers and the ability to release his tax returns, all this could get a whole lot worse for Team Trump. We've never had a president under this much legal scrutiny. And it's not because it's a partisan witch hunt, as the president says. The constant stream of ethics investigations in his administration seem like proof that tone comes from the top. And no amount of fact-free rage tweeting is going to change that. And that's your reality check.
Thank you so much, John. You mentioned Scott Pruitt. Do we know whatever became of the lotion situation? Was that resolved?
You had to bring it back to the lotion.
Yeah, he always does.
You know, look, I think that is, in retrospect, among the least of his sins in terms of legal severity, but by far the creepiest.
Yeah, thank you for putting a finer point on that. Yeah, it's not supposed to be a get-rich-quick scheme to be on the cabinet.
No.
Thank you.